Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. In this video, I will discuss about osteogenesis imperfecta, that is why. Osteogenesis imperfecta was first described by the British physician Sir Harry G.G. Gardner in 1895. Gardner observed and documented the condition in his medical practice, noting the characteristic features of brittle bones, frequent fractures, and other related symptoms. However, the comprehensive understanding of osteogenesis imperfecta and its genetic basis has evolved significantly since Gardner's initial observation. The condition was further studied and characterized in subsequent years, leading to the identification of its genetic causes and the various types of OI. Osteogenesis imperfecta, also known as brittle bone disease, is a genetic disorder characterized by fragile bones that crack easily, often with little or no apparent cause. The condition can vary widely in severity, with symptoms ranging from mild to severe. It is primarily caused by defects in the production of collagen, a key protein in connective tissue. Symptoms include fragile bones, short stature, less dense bones, frequent fractures, joint hyperlaxity, skin soft and slightly translucent, with a tendency to bruise easily, sensorineural hearing loss, dentinogenesis imperfect, and respiratory problems. Osteogenesis imperfecta is classified into several types, ranging from mild to severe. Type 1, the most common and mild form, individuals typically have a normal life expectancy with frequent fractures during childhood and some bone deformities. Type 2 is also severe form, often resulting in stillbirth or death shortly after birth due to severe bone deformities and respiratory. Type 3 is a severe most form with progressive deformity and frequent fractures leading to the significant physical disability, and type 4 is a moderate form with symptoms similar to type 1 but often with more bone deformities and variable severity. Osteogenesis imperfecta is caused by mutation in genes responsible for producing type 1 collagen, a critical protein for bone strength and structure. The prevalence of osteogenesis imperfecta is estimated to be 1 in 15,000 to 20,000 individuals worldwide. Prevalence can vary based on the specific type of OI and the geographic region. Some types of OI are rarer than others, which can influence overall prevalence, increase awareness, and advancements in genetic testing have improved diagnosis, which may impact reported prevalence figures. Earlier and more accurate detection can lead to more precise prevalence estimates. The primary genes involved in osteogenesis imperfecta are COL1A1, which encodes one of the two alpha genes of type 1 collagen. Mutations in this gene are associated with several types of OI, and COL1A2, which encodes the other alpha gene of type 1 collagen. Mutations in COL1A2 gene can also cause OI. Collagen type 1 alpha 1 gene is present on long arm of chromosome 17, consists of 52 exons, and size of gene is about 18. Diagnosis of OI is based on clinical evaluation, that is, assessment of physical symptoms and family history. Genetic testing, which identifies mutations in COL1A1 and COL1A2. Bone density scan evaluates bone density and structural abnormalities and radiographic images. The management and therapy of osteogenesis imperfecta are multidisciplinary and focused on improving quality of life, preventing fractures, enhancing bone strength, and addressing any associated symptoms. While there is no cure for OI, various interventions can significantly improve the function and well-being of affected individuals. A team of specialists is often involved in the care of individuals with OI, including orthopedic surgeons, endocrinologists, physical therapists, pain specialists, geneticists, and dentists and audiologists. Some individuals with OI, particularly those with more severe forms, experience hearing loss due to middle ear abnormalities. Regular hearing assessment should be done. Hearing aids or other assistive hearing devices may be recommended to help individuals with hearing impairment. Pain relief medications such as acetaminophen or non-steroid anti-inflammatory drugs can help to manage discomfort from fractures or other bone-related issues. In severe cases, stronger pain management strategies, including opioids or nerve blocks, may be used temporarily under medical supervision. This is all about osteogenesis imperfecta. Thanks for watching my video. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe my channel for more health insights. Share this video with your friends and family to spread awareness. If you have any queries or personal experience with this disorder, drop comments in comment box. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of yourself. Thank you very much.